Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to quickly edit typos with ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome to another episode of the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 10,000 other people that have subscribed to this show and get notifications every week when I release a new tutorial. So, ProPresenter 7, along with 6, 5, there's just a lot there. And it's very possible that you're not capitalizing on all of the abilities that it has to do things that are really awesome. One of those things, though, is pretty straightforward, but if you don't know, you don't know. So let's head over to my computer and I'll show you the little feature that they've included in ProPresenter 7 that enables you to fix typos really fast. So here we are in ProPresenter 7, and let's say I'm doing church here and I notice, wait, there are a couple of typos in here. A mighty fortress is our gob. A bullwinkle never failing, all our helper he amid the food of mortal Jills prevailing. That's not right at all. So how do we fix that? Right click on it and go to quick edit right here. And now you can just click in there and change that mighty fortress is our god, not a bullwinkle. A bulwark, never failing. Our helper, he amid the, not food, but flood of mortal ills prevailing. So just that quickly, I can fix it. Quite frankly, I've done this during a song while we're singing the slide before and no one knew. So this is really quick, as opposed to sometimes people say, oh, well, I'll just go into edit slide and do it that way. But notice, to get back out of this, then you have to go back up here to show, and then you have to click on it at that point. So that's not good. I've got an alternate theme on this, so that's why it's looking a little odd. So if we go to this screen, that's the one that it's set to look correctly. Now, I will say we do have some limitations with this. So right click, quick edit. Notice that while I can change the text, this is quick edit. Think of this as your typos editor. Well, I cannot change the font. I can't do anything like that. It's just really for typos. If you need to do more, then you need to go in to the slide. If you need to apply another theme, then we've got that ability with the themes here. Or up here, if you need to change how many lines are on each slide, reflow is for that. So there are various editors that do various things, and knowing which one does what will really help your ProPresenter game. So use the quick edit if you need to change a typo. But don't use it if you need to do other things. Use the appropriate editor for whatever you need to do. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address on that page, and I'll make a login for you for free, automatically, and you can do that at that time. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.